So in atheist worldview, sorry, in theist worldview, what we are presupposing is logic. All this transcendental categories like logic, knowledge, these have come from God. It's like a CPU that has been inbuilt in us, and that has been come from God. And this is how we are saying we can do logic, because like logic, knowledge, these are immaterial things
Yeah, but
which
do you have
cannot.
any reason for thinking so?
It's
Or
a
are you just
worldview. It
presupposing? Are you just
is
presupposing it?
right. I'm
Okay.
presupposing it's a worldview.
Huh.
Whereas, like the argument is, it gives a coherent picture. If I am presupposing, it gives meaning to things. Howas, atheist worldview does not account for any of this. It
If
just
I
grants
presuppose,
itself. Huh, it
yeah,
just
but
grants itself.
presupposing is a Pradeep, presupposing is a game can anyone can play, right? You presuppose
True,
it
true.
as being the work of God. I can presuppose it at something else. Do you think that would be valid?
But what do
I'm
you have?
questioning the
Like,
foundation
see,
of it. I'm questioning whether presupposing
right.
something. Listen,
Right.
listen. I'm saying, do you think presupposing something is valid grounds for something to be taken seriously?
If you are looking at it like a, suppose, like the question of kalam, right? The kalam, this thing,
Cosmological
like
argument, huh?
right, like causation, hope, matlab there should be a creator for anything. Like if you see, if you look at from a atheist point of view, every if you categorize things into say things which we definitely know have been made and things which we don't know have been made,
Or
then
not,
if you
huh?
ca do a categorization, then you will come to know that things which you have knowledge are, which whatever is made have been made because of somebody. And whatever things you don't know, whether it has been made or not, you are taking an exception and saying, nahi, kuch nahi ho sakta iska, matlab this has been come.
No, no, no,
So,
no, no, no,
हाँ,
no. I'm not saying कुछ नहीं हो सकता. I'm saying I don't
हाँ,
know.
right. So
Yeah.
since you are saying you don't know, you are taking a middle ground. But then exception will
What is
be,
the other side?
हाँ,
There is no
मतलब
middle ground because when I say I don't know, I'm not making a belief statement. I'm
right.
stating a fact that I don't know. What is the middle ground there?
True. That is your perception on this topic. Fine. But what
It is
about
not a
like,
perception. It is a fact that I don't know.
okay, right. ठीक है, we'll grant it. चलो, you don't
But
know,
then
लेकिन मैं,
can we return to
हाँ,
the question that I asked you?
right.
Do you think that if we just presuppose something, it is valid grounds for that thing to be taken seriously?
As per worldview, it is. It gives a coherent picture. That is what I'm saying. See, if I
Anything
don't
can give
presuppose,
anything. See, if I presuppose that the laws of logic were accidentally created by a dragon's fart, does that give me any
fine.
meaning?
Like you can presuppose Pupudu Gupudu has made everything, right?
Gopudu
Nice, right? So
Gopudu
you can presuppose Pupudu Gupudu has made everything, but then
really
the
famous.
characteristics of Pupudu Gupudu has to be supernatural.
I
If
never
you
said
are,
pre.
if
Listen, listen. First of all, I never clarified what Popud Gupudu was.
I
That
am,
person and other people have assumed that it is a creator. I never specified it. But
but
I'm saying ki presupposing something does not take me any closer to the truth. I'm just filling a gap in my understanding with my imagination.
okay, so these are like what I'll say, these are like logical metaphysical truths which are immaterial. If you are saying these are
What
logical,
are
like
logic? The laws of logic?
the presupposition, I am
The
saying just because, one
presupposition.
second,
How do you know the presupposition is a truth?
philosophical,
The
how
laws of
would you
logic
say,
are a
okay.
truth. The laws of logic are true, but the presupposition about where they came from is just imagination.
Let me just, you are saying presupposition is imagination. Fine. Worldview. That is what I'm saying. It is a worldview. However, how do you account for laws of logic? If you are saying it is a man-made and not discovered...
No, I'm saying I don't know. I told you, I'm saying I don't know. Fine, I'm not presupposing anything. I'm acknowledging that the laws of logic exist. And I'm saying that I don't know where they came from.
Okay. So you are saying laws of logic, you don't know where it has came from. How about knowledge itself? How do you know that knowledge exists? Do you have knowledge about laws of logic?
Yeah. Are you going towards a presuppositional argument?
No, basically it is you...
Because the presuppositional... I'll tell you why it doesn't work. The presuppositional argument doesn't work because thinking of a presupposition as true in and of itself is pointless. Because anyone can presuppose anything.
But there is a category difference in anything. Like, if you are saying laws of logic is absolute, okay. Suppose absolute means there cannot be any exception.
I'm not saying that. I'm saying
let me paint the red. Fine.
Pradeep, you can go ahead. There's no D in your name. So if you are saying that the laws of logic exist, I agree with you. I don't know anything other than that. Maybe there is a place in the universe where they don't apply. But to whatever extent we do know them, they seem to apply. And that is enough for me. I'm not presupposing anything. I'm simply acknowledging what is observed.
Okay. Let me address that as well. See, if you are saying laws of logic is consistent, okay, I'll not put you are saying, because whatever I say, you are like, I'm not assuming anything. So okay. I'll give it a, if a agnostic is saying laws of logic is consistent, okay, these are absolute truth, then thinking that there is a possibility of other world, which does not have laws of logic, would be an exception. It will be almost in the same realm that I am presupposing to counter that laws of logic ka entity itself. Laws of logic is absolute, and we don't have any other examples which violate this. Then I can presuppose, obviously I'll not know the truth 100%, that is I can presuppose, since these are absolute, there has to be absolute entity which has made laws of logic.
Why can't laws of logic themselves be absolute? Why is there there is laws of logic that we are observing. Why are you looking for something above that made it? Why can't the laws of logic themselves be absolute?
Then if you are
I'm not saying
if we are saying laws of logic is absolute and it is immaterial and it is sort of a truth, then it automatically, you're putting it in a category of God itself.
No, I'm not. I'm just saying laws of logic are perhaps absolute.
But then how would you account for laws of logic if it is not material?
How would you account for God?
Right. If I cannot account for God, I only have a...
In the same way, I can't account for laws of logic. But then point is this. There are laws of logic. You and I both agree on that?
Yeah, fine. Right.
You are trying to put something above laws of logic that caused laws of logic or made laws of logic when you don't have any reason to do so. And you are saying laws of logic are absolute, but they need a creator. And I'm saying there is no need to say that. You can just say laws of logic are there. I don't know where they came from.
But then, laws of logic in an immaterial world, how would you justify it without a sort of a... It is not created. It is rather discovered, because it doesn't change. Just because one person thinks something, all the languages...
All that is understood. I'm asking something specific. Tell me, what is the problem with thinking that the laws of logic don't need a creator and are just absolute?
But then you're granting yourself as the laws of logic exist without a justification. You're understanding the problem with this. Laws of logic itself.
Do you have a justification for God?
But that same argument will apply to you as well. Do you have a justification?
For I'm laws saying, of logic? See, I'm not imagining then, something. I'm not presupposing something. I'm stopping at laws of logic. You're the one who's going one step above that and saying that there must be something above it. And I'm saying there is no reason to do so.
But then same argument will apply to you for laws of logic. Why are you even saying laws of logic exist?
We are not disagreeing about the existence of laws of logic, Pradeep. You and I both agree that the laws of logic exist, right?
But then you're that is true. But then I am saying the argument, the criticism that you are making against me of thinking something one step upar mein kyun le raha hun, the same argument can be put against you for explaining laws of.
What am I adding above law?
Irrespective of whatever
what am, you are adding. Pradeep, yeah. What am I adding above laws of logic?
Irrespective of that, how would a...
No. Hold on. You just told me that I'm making the same mistake as you. When I say that you're adding something above laws of logic that is unnecessary, you say I'm doing the same. Tell me, what am I adding above laws of logic?
Okay. Let me just rephrase it like this. God would be immaterial, okay, supreme creator, sort of immaterial.
I've heard that fiction. There is no basis for it. Answer my question. What did I add above laws of logic?
Nothing.
Then how am I making the same mistake as you?
Okay, that does not make laws of logic material or as an agnostic.
I didn't say they're material. I didn't say they're material.
Then how would you justify
laws of... I don't know why you're
going
in directions that I never started to go in. I'm saying...
You have...
Laws of logic... Pradeep, hold on. Laws of logic exist, correct?
What is the justification as a...
Just answer my questions. This will go much faster. Just
in my worldview, it is.
Just answer the question. Just answer the question and yes and no. Okay? Laws of logic exist. Correct?
In my worldview, it is. Yes.
In my worldview, also they exist.
Okay. But then what
laws of logic exist?
Listen, Pradeep.
Pradeep, I'm going to cut the call if you keep talking over me.
Yeah.
Laws of logic exist. Yes?
Yes.
Do we know where laws of logic comes from? I'm not asking what you believe. I'm asking what you know.
God.
Huh?
God.
You know that laws of logic come from God?
Or
do you believe that laws of logic come from God?
Logical truths. Absolute.
Do you know if laws of logic come from God, or do you believe that laws of logic come from God?
I would say I believe.
Yeah. So you don't know that they come from God?
I believe. It's in my worldview.
You believe it, but do you know it?
Yes, I know it.
No, you don't. And that is the fault here. You are using your imagination to create a superstructure above laws of logic, and you have no basis for it. You don't know it, you just believe it. And when push comes to shove, you are forced to just say that you know it. You don't know it. You can't know it. There is no way. If you know it, tell me how you know it.
Because we have mind. We can rationalize in the immaterial world. So, it cannot be explained by science. These are...
None of that answers how you know that laws of logic come from God.
It is a presupposition. That is presuppositional argument.
A presupposition means a belief. I'm not asking why you believe so. I'm asking how you know so.
It's a belief.
Yeah, so you don't know. Right? You don't know, right?
It's a belief.
You don't know, right?
I don't know.
That's it. That's all I wanted to ask.
Can I
move on to someone else?
One second. Can I, the questions were directed to me rather than I should have asked you a few. Do I get a 5-minute thing so that I can...
5 minutes, nahin, you have...
Two minutes.
You have one minute.
Okay,
go on.
1 minute.
Make your last thing.
Right. So, how would you... you are saying that laws of logic exist. We don't agree. But how would you account for laws of logic?
I don't know. I know that they exist, but I don't know why or where from.
But how do you know the laws of logic exist?
because I can apply laws of logic and I can use laws of logic and they work.
But that is like arbitrary figment of imagination.
No, same way. It is demonstrable. I can use laws of logic to make computers work, to do everyday work. Laws of logic help us make sense of the universe.
But how would you account for it?
I told you, don't know.
Then it is as arbitrary.
The universe is a certain way. We look at it and we see that it works a certain way. We write those rules down and they become the laws of logic. Simple. But we don't know why the universe is this way. And I'm not presupposing anything. I'm simply saying this is how the universe works. I don't know why, but this is how it works.
Do you know laws of logic absolutely is true? 100%
it exists. I told you, I don't know. There may be circumstances where they're not true. But to whatever extent to whatever extent I do know, they work and they seem to
be. Do you believe laws of logic exist?
Pradeep, why are you asking me the same question over and over again? In this conversation, I've told you 15 times that I think they exist. Yeah.
Because this is the same line of questioning you gave me. Do you believe God?
No, it is not. Because I was talking about something that you were presupposing, and I'm not presupposing the laws of logic. You and I both agreed that the laws of logic exist. I'm not presupposing anything. You are presupposing.
I can cross-examine your worldview without granting my to be true.
You are free to cross-examine my worldview. I'm just pointing out that my worldview is not presupposing anything above laws of logic.
That is fine. Laws of logic.
We can talk some other time, okay?
By the grace of
Upudu Gupudu, we'll talk some other time.
Yes, Upudu Gupudu for the
win. Bye bye.
Bye bye.